Hi everyone, my name is Ali and in this video I'm going to share with you exactly how to set up your Amazon Seller Central account. So the first step to become an Amazon seller is to go to sell.amazon.com. Before I click on sign up, I want to give you a quick tip, guys. As you can see, it says $40 a month is your subscription fee, which is for professional seller accounts. But if you want an individual account that is $1 per sale and avoid that monthly subscription fee, you can scroll down and click on become an individual Amazon seller. And once you sell more than 40 items per month, you can switch on the professional account. So let's go ahead and click on sign up. On this page, you'll need to sign in with your email or phone number, but if you don't have an account yet, you can click on create your Amazon account. Here you need to enter your name, email, password, and click on next. So this is where we are going to start registering for our account. As you can see, it says before starting, please ensure you have the following handy. We may require additional information or documents later. So they need a business and contact address, which could be your business address if you own an LLC or corporation, and if you're a sole prop, you can enter your home address. They need a phone number, a credit card like a Visa or MasterCard, not a debit card because they don't accept debit cards here. And finally, identity details like your passport and driving license. So here you should enter your business location. It says if you have a business, select the country where your business is registered, and if you don't have a business, select the country of your residence. So let's go ahead and select Canada. Next, it says enter your business type, like a privately owned business, like an LLC or corporation, or if you are a sole prop, select individual. So for the purpose of this video, we are going to select individual and enter our full name here. On this page, you are going to be required to enter some personal information about yourself, starting with country of citizenship, country of birth, date of birth, your business address. Now, if you don't have an office, it's absolutely fine. You can enter your home address here. Next, you need to enter your phone number, and you should enter a PIN that you're going to receive by SMS or call. So go ahead and select your area code, enter your phone number, click on send SMS, and they'll send you a code, insert that code, and afterwards click on next. So now you're going to be required to fill out some billing information, starting off with your credit card details. You want to enter your credit card number, your expiry date, and the cardholder's name. I always recommend entering the credit card of the business or the person that the account is registered under, so there won't be any discrepancies here. So enter all information as well as your billing address and click on next. Alright, so now we should enter some information about our store and our product as well. Starting off with store name, you can enter the name of your brand if you're doing a private label business, but don't overthink about it because you can always change it later. The next question is, do you have a UPC code for your products? So if you are just starting off, you probably don't have any, so go ahead and click on no. By the way, in this video I share with you exactly how to apply for a UPC exemption on Amazon, so make sure to click on the eye icon and watch it later. The next question is, are you the manufacturer or brand owner of any of the products you want to sell? So if you are doing retail arbitrage and buy products from Walmart or let's say Costco and you resell them on Amazon, you should click no. But if you are a brand owner and you do private label, click on yes. Let's click on next. All right, now it's gonna ask you to upload your passport and some additional documents like bank account statement. So go ahead and upload your passport and credit card statement and click on submit. All right, we are almost done now, and it's giving us a note that in regards to address verification, it says a postcard containing a code will be mailed to the address mentioned below. Please confirm the address to receive the postcard. Once you confirm the address, it takes 7 days for the mail to arrive. Once you make sure the address is correct, you want to go ahead and click on confirm and check your mailbox every single day. So once you receive your code, you just want to log into your Amazon account and enter your code on this page and click on next, and you'll have access to your Seller Central account. All right, so by now you probably received your PIN number in the mail and gain access to your Seller Central account here. It's very easy to navigate. If you want to add a product, you can click on add products under the category menu. There are other menus like inventory, orders, advertising, stores, reports, and performance, and I have at least one video about each of these menus, so make sure to watch my other videos as well. So if you found this video helpful, make sure to click on like and subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to check out my new Amazon FBA Mastery course where I share how to find a high demand profitable product, source it from Alibaba, and how to launch it on Amazon. It's a very affordable course. I leave a link down in the description, so make sure you check it out. Now, if you have any questions, comment below and make sure to watch my next video over here. You can click on one of my next videos and watch them right now. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.